Okay, Be'ezrat Hashem, we're going to start. I think we're starting from where up to. Yeah, the Mishnah. Let's see. Be'ezrat Hashem, what's going on? Is it Daf Pehei today?
Pehvav.
So Daf Pehvav, we'll start from the Mishnah. Bat Yisrael me'ureset lekohen. A Bat Yisrael who's engaged to the Kohen, or so she on her own is not allowed to eat Terumah, but what's going to allow her to eat Terumah is going to be her relationship with a Kohen. So, but if she's only engaged to the Kohen, we say that she's not allowed to eat Terumah midrabanan, or me'uberet lakot mikohen. She's pregnant from a Kohen, not married, but the fact that she has a baby Kohen, if she'll have the baby, she'll be allowed to eat. But because, or she was married and the Kohen died, or whatnot. But because she's not actively married to Kohen and she doesn't have a son who's a Kohen, she's not allowed to eat Terumah. Or Shomeret Yavam La Kohen. Again, her husband died and she has a what's it called? She's waiting for the brother-in-law. She's not married to him. Shomeret Yavam La Kohen. She can't eat Terumah. V'chen bat kohen li Yisrael. A bat kohen on her own could eat terumah.
We've had this before. We've had this before.
Yeah. A lot of it we have. We're repeating it because we're giving you all the rules. V'chen bat kohen li Yisrael. A bat kohen who's married to Yisrael. Lo tochal b'terumah. She can't eat terumah. Why? Because even Erusin is posel her from eating terumah.
And the first three is different. This is... She's terminated, that's it, no more. The first three, soon they're going to be eating Terumah.
But it's telling you this point, that because you're in a relationship with Israel, she lost it.
Forever.
Yeah, well, until she leaves him. Right? V'chem bat kohen l'Yisrael lo tochal b'trumah. Bat Yisrael me'ureset la'levi. If a bat Yisrael is engaged to a Levi, me'uberet me'levi, shomeret yavam le'levi, so any one of the same three that we have by Kohen. V'chen, so now, V'chen bat Levi li Yisrael, or bat Levi is any one of the above to Yisrael, lo tochal v'ma'aser. The same way it happens with Terumah, that just being engaged to a Kohen, or having a baby, being pregnant with the Kohen's baby doesn't give you Terumah. So too, being engaged or being pregnant or being shomeret yavam to a Levi doesn't give you ma'aser. And the bat Levi who on her own does eat ma'aser, if she gets engaged to Yisrael or shomeret yavam, whatever, she doesn't eat anymore. So far we had two cases. We had a bat Yisrael to a Kohen and a bat Yisrael to a Levi. She's starting off with nothing and she didn't get anything. Now we're going to start off, but she's not losing anything. Or you have the Bat Levi losing the Ma'aseh because she went to Israel, or Bat Kohen losing the Terumah because she went to Israel. Now we're going to combine the two. You have Bat Levi Me'ureset LeKohen. You have a Bat Levi, she eats Ma'aser, she's Me'ureset to a Kohen who eats Terumah, right? So now, from the fact that she's me'ureset to the Kohen, or me'uberet la Kohen, or shmeyavah me'kohen, v'chem bat Kohen le'levi, lo tochal, lo b'trumah v'lo b'ma'aser. So she had terumah, let's say it's about Kohen le'levi. She had terumah, Levi doesn't get terumah. So she loses the terumah because she connected to Levi. And what she had, she also loses because the Kohen doesn't, because the Levi doesn't get terumah, so she loses that too.
Israel now.
Maaseh,
she
loses Maaseh. Good. Says the Gemara, what are you talking about when you say in the Mishnah, Tochal b'maaseh, lo tochal b'maaseh, nari maaseh? What does Maaseh have to do with anything? V'tehe zara. Zara mi lo achla b'maaseh? Even if she wasn't a Levi, anyone could eat Maaseh. The way we understand that the dine maaser are dinim of ownership. Who gets it? Who do I give it to? I have an obligation to give it to a Levi. But there is no kiddusha in the maaser that should say that someone else is not allowed
anybody
to eat,
can
it.
Eat it.
Right? Says Gemara, Amar Rav Nachman, Amar Shmuel Ha, Mane Rabbi Meiri. This Mishnah goes like Rabbi Meir. Da Amar Maaser Rishon, Asur Lezarim. He says Maaser Rishon is forbidden to a Zar, just like Terumah is forbidden to a Kohen. It's not like I said, it's not just a monetary relationship. There's a certain holiness, Kiddushah, to the Maaser, and only Levim can eat it. Rashi, Milo Achla b'Maaser kol Zar lo yochal Kodesh ketiv. When it says a Zar can't eat, it says he can't eat Kodesh. U'Maaser Rishon lo yikre Kodesh. Says Rabbi Meir that says Maaser Rishon asul azrim. Detanya teruma la kohen u'Maaser Rishon le Levi devre Rabbi Meir. What does it mean teruma la kohen u'Maaser Rishon le Levi? That you just give it to them? Look in Rashi. Teruma la kohen netinata la kohen u'Maaser Rishon le Levi. Maaser Rishon you give the Levi. Katani Maaser le Levi. It says Maaser goes to the Levi. Dumya de teruma la kohen. The same way teruma goes to the kohen. Ma teruma, just like teruma. Achilata kenetinata. The way you eat it is the way you give it. Meaning, the same person you give it to is the only person who's allowed to eat it. Kohen, right? Velo lezar af maaser lelevi. So too maaser that you give to a levi. Achilato lelevi velo lezar is only eaten by the person you give it to, who's the levi and not to a zar. The ilav hachi. If you're not going to say that. Svira lei l'Rabbi Meir teruma l'may katanila. Why does he have to tell you teruma in the same piece with maaser? Nihi de maaser etzirich alei le'oruye. Delo yahiv nan lei le'kohen k'Rabbi Lazar ben Azaria. Even though I has to teach you that you don't give teruma maaser to a kohen, like Rabbi Lazar ben Azaria, who says, even though it says to the Levi, kohanim are also called Leviim, Ela teruma, you only give the kohanim teruma. Ela teruma lamali. What do you have to tell me that teruma goes to a kohen? There's nobody in the whole history of Torah scholarship that said not to give teruma to a kohen. So you tell me maaser to the Levi, yeah. But to tell me teruma to kohen is not important. Must be, he told you teruma la kohen to give you a frame of reference for how the maaser goes to the Levi. The way Maaseh goes to the Levi is the way Terumah goes to the Kohen. Just like Terumah that you give to the Kohen, it goes to the Kohen and he's the only one that can eat it. So to Maaseh that you give to the Levi, goes to the Levi and he's the only one that can eat it. The od mi de ka'amar le Rabbi Eliezer. The next line is Lashon heter mechlal derbi imi enami be'isu ve'eter ayri. So that we didn't really read that yet. Let's see the next line. So da'amar Rabbi Meir de tanya Terumah la Kohen u'Maaseh Rishon le Levi devre Rabbi Meir. Rabbi Elazar, and they take out Ben Azariah in this one. Rabbi Elazar, Matiro la Kohen. Rabbi Elazar is Matir for the Kohen. We Matiro. He allows it to go to the. He allows the Kohen to eat it.
What? The Levi?
No, the Maaser.
Maaser Levi. That's what I said.
Right. No, we didn't understand what you meant. Right. Mi de Tanya right. Matiro Michlal de Ika Manda Asar. Somebody was oser, ela ema notno af le kohen. You could give it to the kohen.
Rashi,
mechlal deika lemanda asar maaser le kohen. Does somebody oser maaser to a kohen leechol b'tmiha? Rahavadai kohanim lav zarim ninhu. Even if you say that just like teruma has to go to a not to a zar, so to maaser can't go to a zar. But who would say that a kohen is a zar to maaser? Because he's more he's Bnei Levi. He's also called Bnei Levi, right? The Kedah Amar LeKaman, the Kohanim Ikru Levi.
Because the opposite also that Levi can eat the Torah of the Kohen.
Leviim are not called Kohanim.
Why the Kohanim came from Leviim?
That doesn't make Leviim Kohanim.
So why make Kohanim Leviim? Why would the opposite?
Because it says a Kohanim Bnei Levi. We'll see it on the next page. It says the Gemara notno af the Kohen, the Kaamar lekaman ta'amar. The Gemara says later you even give it to the Kohen. Says the Gemara. My ta'amad Rabbi Meir. What's Rabbi Meir's reason that he says that a ma'aser is only eaten to the Levim? Amar Rav Acha bered Rava Mishemed de Gemara. Rav Acha, the son of Rabbah, said in the name of the Gemara, Rashi says, Mishmed de Gemara, very interesting. Kach kibel mirabo, he received it from his Rebbe. Mirabo, and his Rebbe from his Rebbe, Ad Rabbi Meir. straight to Rabbi Meir, Sheshama Mishmo, he heard it from him. Belav min da'ate kamifaresh leta'amad Rabbi Meir. He's not explaining Rabbi Meir's reason with his own brain. He has tradition going back to Rabbi Meir that this is Rabbi Meir's reason. Ki et ma'asar b'nei Yisrael, back in the Gemara, ki ma'asar b'nei Yisrael, asher yarimu lahashem terumah. What a ma'asar b'nei Yisrael that they separate for Hashem as the terumah. Why they use the word terumah? Ma terumah asura lezarim. So it's comparing it to terumah. Ma terumah, you can't say that it's like terumah that you give it to the Kohanim, because it says it goes to the Levim. So ma terumah asur lezarim is asur to strangers. Af ma'aser. Right, af ma'aser rishon asur lezarim. So to ma'aser rishon doesn't go to strangers. Ima, you're making a hekesh. Ima teruma chayavin alea mita vehomish. If a zar eats it, he's chayav mita bidei shamayim. You'll say ma'aser is also chayav mita bidei shamayim. Ma, just like teruma, if a zar eats it, he has to pay a premium. He has to pay a penalty of a homish. Maybe you'll say the same by ma'aser. Af ma'aser chayavin alav mita vehomish. Amar kera, it says by teruma, umetu bo ki haleluhu. They'll die in it when they profane it. Bo is a mi'ud, bo velo b'ma'aser. V'yasav hamishito alav. It says when you eat it b'shogeg, you add a fifth onto it. Alav, on it. Bo is a mi'ud, velo b'ma'aser. Alav on it, and I'm ma'aser. Even though I'm comparing them, but for these things, I'm excluding them from the comparison. So that's what it be mi'ud. Mi'ud has a kesh. Ashiyarimu la Hashem teruma, comparing ma'aser to teruma. And in order not to compare it all the way, I have bo and alav to say bo belot bin ma'aser and alav velo bin ma'aser. Verabanan, who say that ma'aser is mutar to be eaten to anybody. So what do they do with this comparison that the Torah says ki ma'asar b'nei Yisrael ashiyarimu la Hashem teruma? Says the Gemara, ma teruma tovelet. Af ma'aser rishon nami tovel. Just like teruma has the power to be tovel something, tovel means, doesn't mean dipping in the mikveh. It means that before you separate the teruma, the whole mixture is asur, right? So too. So too over here, before you start. So too over here, before you take the ma'aser off, the whole mixture is asur. That's called tovel. It's called tevel before you separate it.
That means mixed tevel, right?
Right. And it's also, don't say, well, I'm going to separate the terumah later. Terumah is a little bit. Don't worry, Kohen, I'll give it to you later. Before you take it, can't eat it at all. Av ma'aser isho nami tovel. Look in Rashi. Ma terumah tovelet. You see the Rashi? Maturuma tovele, first word. It's the last words online. Maturuma tovele. Shekol zeman shelohu frasha. As long as it wasn't separated. Hayavin mita al achilato. Yechayav mita for eating it. Al achilato shel tevel. Daha mita ketiv. It says mita. Af ma'asir ishon tovel. Ma'asir ishon is also tovel. And yechayav mita if you eat it. Now it's a little bit of, it's more of a chidush there. Af agav debidide leka mita. By teruma, I understand that if you eat the tevel, meaning the raw fruits that you didn't take any teruma from, I can understand there's mita, because in here is the teruma that there's mita on. So you could understand that before you designate where the teruma is ki'ilu spread all over the whole thing. So any piece that you eat has that mita piece in it. Whereas ma'aser, there's no mita on eating ma'aser, even according to the Bimi'ir that says that only a kohen could eat it, there's no mita if someone else eats it. Not mita b'homish. There's only a lav. So why should you be hayav mita? It says that's after you separate, but before you separate it, it's tevel, the same as tevel for teruma. Just like tevel teruma, if you eat it, there's mita. So to tevel for ma'aser, there's mita. What's that?
You do it with your mind.
Yes, but that's a chidush. It's true, but you have no real good way of knowing that out of this point yet. But you're correct. Either you knew it from somewhere, or you guessed well, or you had something, but you got it. We have there's a pasuk. I don't remember the pasuk, but there's a pasuk. Okay. Uchdetanya, Rabbi Yossi Omer, Yaakov, I might say, V'nechshav lachem terumatchem. V'nechshav is even b'machshava. Uchdetanya, Rabbi Yossi Omer, Yaakov, lo yeh chayav. I might say, only chayav mita. Ela al tevel shelo huram mimenu kol ikar. That you didn't take anything from. Huram mimenu, if they took out. Teruma gedola de teruma. But you didn't separate out the Maaser Rishon. Maaser Rishon velo Maaser Sheni. If they took the Maaser Rishon, but not Maaser Sheni. Vafilu Maaser Ani. Even the Maaser that they give in the third and sixth year to the Anim. Minayin, how do you know that you hayav for eating the table that these things weren't separated from? Talmud Lomar, it says, Lo tuchal le'echol b'sh'arecha. You cannot eat in your gates. Right? In your gates means outside of Yerushalayim. Ulhalan hu omer ve'achelu b'sh'arecha v'saveu. And they'll eat it in their gates and they'll be happy. So, ve'achelu b'sh'arecha, that's the pasuk of Tevil. If you look in number hey, if you have the pesukim on the side, ki techalel la'aser. כל מעשר תבואת איכה בשנה השלישית שנת המעשר ונתת ללוי להגיע ליתום ולמנה ואכלו בשעריך וסבאו. Is that Maaser Ani? It's all the years. That's going on all the years. Ki techale is like for all the stuff. So you see that Maaser Ani is what? Is Vachelu B'Sh'arecha? Ma She'arecha Ha'amur Lehalan. You're right, that is Maaser Ani, Jimmy. Includes Maaser Ani. Av She'arecha Ha'amur Kan. So too, when it says Lo Tuchal Le'chol B'Sh'arecha, includes Maaser Ani. Ve'amar Hamana Lo Tuchal. Lo Tuchal Le'chol. You can't eat it, I guess, until you separate it. So you see from these pesukim lo tuchal lechol b'sharecha, and the fact that it says b'sharecha tochelenu, and it v'achelu b'sharecha, right? So we see that even maaser sheni and maaser ani is tovel. So the question is, now I have two pesukim that maaser is tovel. I have this pasuk of lo tuchal lechol b'sharecha, and I have the hekesh of Asher Yarimu Teruma, Hashem Teruma, which is talking about Maaser. What do I need both for? Says the Gemara, V'ime Hatam, if it would just be from there, Hava Amina, I would say Lelav. Lo Tuchal Le'echol, you get a lav if you eat it. But then you should be Chayav Mita, if you eat Tevil, I wouldn't know. Aval Mito, Mita Lo, Kamash Malan. That's why he has to say both. Want to teach me what's included, Maaser Rishon, Maaser Sheni, Maaser Ani. And want to teach me the penalty that if you don't separate it first, you get, if you eat it, you chaya mita bidei shamayim. Lishna Harina, a different way of understanding the why I need two pisukim. Maaser Rishon de Tavil. I know that Maaser Rishon makes Tevil mid Rabbi Yossi. From Rabbi Yossi's statement. From this Braita. Rabbi Yossi, Ela Tevil Shalom Mekol Ikar. From that Braita, Lo Tuchal L'chuba Sharecha, and so on. But if only from there have Amina Lalav, that there's only a lav. Aval mita lo, but I wouldn't know that you chayav mita. Kamash malaniti. So it taught me that you chayav also mita. B'mayu kimta. So that's the end of the Braita. That's how we know that Rabbi Meir says that Terumah is Asur, Ma'asir is Asur even for Yisraelim, because it compares it to Terumah, not like the Chachamim. Says the Gemara, B'mayu kimta k'Rabbi Meir. What are you saying that it's going like the Mishnah? That says it's like Rabbi Meir, Ema Seifa, Bat Levi, Meureset LeKohen. A Bat Levi is engaged to a Kohen. Ubat Kohen LeLevi, Lo Tocha, Lo Beteruma, Velo BeMaaser. She can't eat not Teruma, not Maaser. Hacha, Maizarut Ika. Doesn't make sense. She's married, she's a Levi, she's allowed to eat Maaser. She got engaged to a Kohen. The Kohen also eats Maaser. Everybody agrees that Kohen is allowed to eat Maaser. He's not worse than the Levi. So why can't she eat Maaser? If she got engaged to a Yisrael who can't eat Maaser, so her potential relationship with the Yisrael precludes her from eating Maaser. But she's engaged to a Kohen. Let's say she got engaged to a Levi. You're going to say she can't eat? She eats. Her husband eats. It's all in the family. The Kohen is even higher. He also eats Maaser. So why can't she eat Maaser? That's the question. So your explanation works in the beginning, but it doesn't work in the end. My Zarut Ika. Says the Gemara, Amar Rav Sheshat. Rav Sheshat says, My ena ochelet de katani, ena notenet reshut. She can't give permission. Litrom. She can't give permission to take the terumah. Rashi, ena notenet, my ena ochelet de katani, kule matnitin legabe maaser. It's a different answer. It's not Rabbi Meir. When it says ena ochelet de maaser, it means that the woman who's engaged to a future husband doesn't have the right to designate that they should take maaser from his foods. Ena notenet reshut litrom. Lo tochal betruma. Rashi says gabi maaser. Right? Ena notenet reshut litrom to take teruman maaser. Rashi, ena noten reshut l'shluha l'trom ma'aser shel arus. She's engaged. Now she wants to be the mistress of the house. She's going to tell them to take the terumah. She can't do it. Ulharim imenu terumat ma'aser. Why? V'havale ketorem shelo midat. It's like doing it without the permission of the owner. Michlal din nisua noten reshut. A married woman is allowed to. Hare, it's not hers either. It's not hers either. Money. Right? Says the Gemara, "In yes, she's allowed to." V'hatanya, we have a brayta. V'achaltem oto bekol makom. You could eat the maaser in all places. Right, that's talking that what they give to the court to the Levi. Atem uvatechem, you and your household. What does have seen you and your household? Limer al nisua bat Yisrael. It teaches about a girl, a bat Yisrael. That she's allowed to, Hare, when you give the money, when you give the ma'aser to the Levi, he has to also give some to the Kohen. Your wife could eat it, she can tell the Kohen, she can take the Trumat Ma'aser and give it to the Kohen. So you see, the wife is authorized to separate ma'aser on your behalf. Mikan, limer al nesua batechem, your house. That means that she's married to you, she's living in your house. She's not an arusa that's living by her father. You wouldn't call a woman living by her father batechem, right? Limer al nesua bat Yisrael shenotenet reshut litrom. Ata omer reshut litrom. You're telling me it's talking about permission to take terumah? O ena ela le'echol. Maybe it's just saying that the wife is allowed to eat ma'aser. Amarta, you said, teruma hamura. Teruma, which is much more hamur. Ochel, the wife eats. Ma'aser akal okoshken. Of course, ma'aser akal, the wife could eat. Even if you hold it, asu lezarim. Ela li meral nesua bat Yisrael, shenotene reshu letrom. That the girl who's engaged is allowed to take teruma for her husband. That's Rav Sheshat's answer for what it means in the Mishnah. Eno ochelet b'maaser doesn't mean eat the maaser. Eno chinami, anybody can eat maaser. It means that she's allowed to give her, give permission to separate the terumot on her husband's behalf. Mor bered Ravina Amar, lomar she'en holkin la ma'aser bebet ha'geranot. When it says lo tochal b'ma'aser, it means that a Bat Yisrael who gets married to a Levi cannot go to where they're giving out ma'aser and get ma'aser. Says the Gemara, Hanicha, it's good. Lemanda Amar Mishum Yehud. The Gemara is going to have a machloket later. Why we don't give ma'aser to a lady? Some say Mishum Yehud, because the lady is going to get it created non-tziniut situation. You have a guy in his silo giving out ma'aser. Ladies come. It's not so kosher. It's out in the fields. It's private. Nobody there. Mishum yichud. So it doesn't make, of course, nobody could take it. Ela leman, it doesn't make a difference if she's a bat kohen, a bat levi, a bat Israel. She doesn't belong there. Ela leman de amar mishum girusha. But if the reason is because maybe she'll get divorced, right? Meaning like this. If I start off as a Bat Yisrael and I marry a Levi, so now I got upgraded. Now they gave me the Maaser license. Now I can go collect Maaser. So I go walk into the silo, I say, hi, I'd like some Maaser. They say, who are you? I'm married to a Levi. Okay, married to a Levi, who's your husband? Oh, nice boy, very nice, and they give him Maaser. And for the next 5 years, she's coming. Then she gets into a fight with the guy, and they separate. She's not stopping to take Maaser. She goes right back in, and she asks for some Maaser. Sure, Mrs. Levy, they didn't hear about the divorce. If that reason only applies if she's a bat Israel. But if she's a bat Levy, so what's the difference? She gets for her husband, she gets for her father. So how come it says a bat Levy that marries a Kohen, she doesn't get? She should get anyway. Right? Dama mishum girusha bat Levi milo achle b'ma'aser. Ul ta'amich girusha bat kohen milo achle b'truma. Says Gemara Ela, and everybody agrees over there. Ela gezera mishum girusha bat Yisrael. All of these people, they said that they can't get, because if we allow them to get on their own, the bat Yisrael will also get. Rashi. V'achi pirushot. After that long, bold piece in Rashi, it says, V'hachi pirusho. Hachi gassina, mobere dervina amar lomar she'en cholkin la ma'aser ve'bet ha'giranot. Hanich leman dama mishum yichud. Eloman dama mishum girusha bat levi mi lo achle b'ma'aser ota'amich. Girusha bat kohen mi lo achle b'truma. Ela gezera mishum girusha bat Yisrael. V'hachi pirusho. Reisha, the beginning that says Bat Yisrael to a Bat Kohen, right, is Ba'achila Mamash. V'Rabbi Meir, and it's Rabbi Meir, meaning even Bat Yisrael Merissa, the Levi, is Rabbi Meir. V'Seifa, when it says a Bat Levi, who's engaged to a Kohen, and a Bat Kohen engaged to a Levi, that it says that they lost the Truma and the Ma'aser, the Katani Legabe Ma'aser, Lomar is to teach me She'en holkin la ma'aser bebet ha'geranot. That they don't give a ma'aser in the bet ha'geranot below ba'ala without a husband. Hu adin le'nisua. And the truth is, the same thing is even after she's married. Like the Gemara is going to ask that, because it doesn't make a difference at this point. Hanicha leman da'amar beperek nosin ala anusa mishum yichud. That they don't let her go alone because of yichud. En holkin tiruma le'isha begorin. It's good. None of them should get. But if the reason is because when she gets divorced, meaning Shema Yigarshena, Ba'ala, maybe husband divorces her. Vetehezara, and now she's not a Levi anymore. Ve'ena kol Yodim, everybody knows. Ve'yachziru v'yitnu turma lezara. Girusha bat Levi, milo achla b'ma'aser. A girusha was a bat Levi, she doesn't need ma'aser. Ve'amai bat Levi, she netarsa lekohen. How come the bat Levi who gets engaged to Kohen, the Katani, and Holkin la ma'aseh begorin, that it says we don't give a bishvil ba'ala amai. Why? Amai gazur barabanan. Ha inami megareshla, even if she divorces her, shapir ka'ach la ma'aseh, because she herself is a Levi. So the Gemara asks back, Tamich, you're asking me this question. Why she shouldn't get now, even if she gets divorced, she gets. Girusha bat kohen. Milo achla betruma. Girusha bat kohen, she doesn't get truma. Kulumar ol tamich, demot vata matnifi. You're asking on the Mishnah legabe ma'aser. Hachinami beperek nosnim de itmar ikar milta. What we said, the main part of this statement. The katani, isha en holkin la tiruma ala gorim. We don't give a woman tiruma in the silo. Uparshin and ta'amam, we said the reason mishum girusha. Vela palig, and they didn't differentiate. Ben bat Yisrael le kohen. They didn't differentiate who her father is and say, oh, her father's a kohen, you can give it to her. Ubat kohen le kohen. Girusha bat kohen milo achlaf. She's the daughter of a kohen, and she married a kohen, and she got divorced. She doesn't need to marry, she does. Ela, so how come over there we didn't say, oh, she's a kohen, and her husband's a kohen, and her father's a kohen. She gets tirumah in the silo. Mishum girusha bat Yisrael. Because what, we're only going to give a lady if we ascertain who her father and her husband is. So therefore, the same thing here. The same thing over here. We don't give a gezerah to bat Yisrael.
What trouble do you call Israel?
Right. Ihachi, back in the Gemara. Ihachi. The reason is because you're afraid she's going to get divorced, so it's not only if she's engaged, she doesn't get truma on the silo. Ihachi, my iria me'ureset, afilu nesu anami. Even if she's married, she still doesn't get. Says Gemara, you're right. I did the Tana Reisha me'ureset, tani nami sefa me'ureset. Because we said the engaged girl doesn't get either. So, because in the Reisha we spoke about me'ureset, in the Sefer we spoke about me'ureset. But in achinami, even after she's married, she doesn't get. Tanu Rabbanan, we learned. Teruma la kohen. Teruma goes to the kohen. Ma'aser rishon le Levi. Ma'aser rishon goes to the Levi. Divrei Rabbi Akiva. That's Rabbi Akiva's opinion. Right? Each one gets what they get. Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah omer. This one is Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah. Le kohen. Meaning, le kohen sounds like ma'aser rishon goes exclusively to kohanim. Velo le Levi. Says Gemara, le kohen velo le Levi? B'tmiha, havadai kira levim kama. The Torah says that you give it to the levim. Ki ma'asa b'nei Yisrael natati la levim. It says you give it to the levim. How can you say give it to the kohanim? Says the Gemara, ema af le kohen. You could also give it to the kohen. Mai ta'amad Rabbi Akiva. Why does Rabbi Akiva say only goes to levim? Dechtiv ele levim tedaber v'amarta alehem. Levim kam nishtai ekira. It's talking about the levim as opposed to the kohanim. Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, the idach, meaning Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, Rabbi Yishu ben Levi, Damar Yishu ben Levi, be'esrim ve'arba'a mekomot, in 24 places in the Torah, or in Tanakh, nekri'u kohanim levim, the kohanim are called levim, ve'ze ahad mehem, ve'akohanim halvim b'nei Sadok. So therefore, they're also called levim. And therefore, Rashi v'tzadok kohen hava v'kara lebanav halvim. V'Rabbi Akiva, hacha, over here where they're called levim, lo matzit amar, tichtiv achaltem oto b'chol makom. Eat in all places. Mi shi yachol le'ochlo b'chol makom. Someone that can eat in all places. Yatza kohen, she'en yachol le'ochlo b'bet ha'kebarot. He can't eat it in the cemetery. Not let in. V'idach, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, when it says Bechol Makom, doesn't mean every place. Kol Makom Dubai, wherever he wants. Meaning, the law by Homa doesn't have to be eaten in walled cities. Not like Maaseh Sheni. Says the Gemara, V'achil le betumat aguf lo laki. And another point, that if you eat it betumat aguf, I know what it has to do with this over here. If you eat it when you're tameh, you don't get malkut. Not like teruma, not like maaseh sheni. Mrs. Pasuk. Okay. One second. Okay, so the Gemara says, Hahu Ginta, there was a garden, Tehave Shakil Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah Ma'aser Rishon Minne. Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah was taking Maaser Rishon in there. He was taking Maaser Rishon from there. Maaser Rishon, normally we say, goes to the Levi. That's Rabbi Akiva's opinion. Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah even give it to a Kohen. Now, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, Rashi says, Kohen Ava. He was a Kohen. Kid Amar ben Berachot. Tehu Asiri le'Ezrai was the 10th generation from Ezra HaKohen. Right? Azar Rabbi Akiva, he played a trick on him. Ahadre lepitcha lebekivre. This garden was next to a cemetery, but the door wasn't by the cemetery. Rabbi Akiva convinced the guy to turn the opening to the cemetery. So the only way in was through the cemetery. And I told you, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, bechol makom, in the cemetery. Let me see you get the maaser now. Right? Ahadre lepitcha lebekivre. Amar, so Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah said, Akiva betarmilo, va'ana haye. Rashi says, Wamsha, Akiva betarmilo. Why does he say tarmilo? Tarmilo is like the rucksack that a shepherd uses. Mishum Rabbi Akiva ra'ayad kaba savu hava. Tarmilo hemet shel or, bastila bilaz, ve'ro'en otem bo pito ve'tolevet zavaro. So he's a shepherd. He's got his food in his backpack. But I'm a Levi. I'm a Kohen. Where am I getting my, what's it called from? I can't get the, from inside. The Gemara is going to, we'll see the Gemara. Maybe there's another pshat there. Pligi bar, Rabbi Yonatan. Aitmar, we learn. Mipne ma kansu Levim. So Rashi says this is a new pshat. Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah holds. Mi karadin, Kohanim can get it with Levim. Rabbi Akiva holds, no. Mi'ikar adin, only Levim. Right? Mipnei ma kansu Levim b'ma'aser. How come they penalized the Levim not to get ma'aser? Rashi, lav le'ilka, it's not going before. Tehacha lav mishum knasa. It's not a knasa. Ela mishum de kohanim nami Levim ikru. Kohanim are also called Levim, keda amaran. Ela da ama bekama duchtim ba'ashas batar de kansinu Ezra. Ezra penalized them. Ubemasechet zota tenan Yohanan kohen gadol he'evir hodayat ma'aser. He stopped them from saying the hodayan ma'aser. V'ama mepnei she'em afrishim oto keteknam. We don't give it properly. Terahamana amar yahava l'rvim v'anan yahivnen l'kohanim. We give it to the kohanim. V'hacha nakat la mishum de bayit de kabay l'mifrach ala mehad Rabbi Akiva. Because we're going to ask about Rabbi Akiva. Pligi bar Yonatan v'sabaya. Had amar shelo alu bime Ezra, v'had amar kedei shismechu kohanim ala bime tumatam. One said because the Leviim, when Ezra came from Bavel, none of the Leviim came along. They were staying in Bavel. We'll see in a minute. So because they didn't come back to second Beit HaMikdash, he says, okay, you guys are not getting ma'asir.
What's it up to him?
Yeah, why not? Beitin, they took it away.
It's a coin.
So what? Ezra said, no, you guys are not coming. Not anymore. Shelo alu bime Ezra. V'had amar, no. Kedei shismechu kohanim ala bime tumatam. Because kohanim need it when they're tameh, they can't eat tenumah. What are they going to eat? We'll give them ma'asir. Bishlam alaman damar shelo alu. If the reason is because they didn't come up. Mishum hachi kansinu, so they penalize them. Ela leman da amar kedei shismechu alav kohanim b'tumatam. The kohanim need money, so you take it away from the levim. Mishum kohanim kansinu levim. Ela kule alma. Everybody agrees. Knasa, the penalty was shelo alubim me'ezra. It was because it didn't come up in the time of Ezra. V'hacha b'hacha mifli. The machloket is, what was the purpose? Right? Mor savar knasa la'aniim. The penalty, it's a penalty. Goes to Aniim. Right? Meaning, you can't give it to anybody, but you give it to Kohanim, Aniim. Umor Savar, and one holds, Kohanim bime tumatam Aniim ninhu. Kohanim, when they're tameh, all of them are like Aniim.
Good, they can eat nothing.
Says the Gemara, Bishlama, it's good. Leman de Amar Kenasa La'aniyim Mishum Hachi Ahadar Rabbi Akiva Lepitcha Lebekivre. If you say it's supposed to go to Aniyim, I know where Rabbi Akiva turned. He said, Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, you're not an Ani. It wasn't for you. Ela lemanda amar lekohanim. According to the opinion that says that it goes to the Kohanim. Amai ahadre lepitcha lebe kivre. Why did he turn the door to the Beit HaKibarot? Hachika amarle. This is what he's telling him. Rashi. If you say it's a knas to the Kohanim, im ita de takanta le Kohanim avai, if you're telling me that it was to all Kohanim, mi have mehadar Rabbi Akiva le pitcha le bekivre, would he turn it around? Nihina mi dekra belvim ketiv, mi or Rabbi Akiva le batad de kansinu aizrahava, was after the knas. So memanavshach, whether it's doraita or drabanan, either way it goes to the Kohanim. Says the Gemara, Hachika Amar. This is what he meant to tell him. I atit betorat knasa. If you're coming because of the knas, it lecha. Then you deserve it. V'ika atit betorat haluka. But if you think that it's yours, mi'ikar adin, let lach. You don't get. Says Gemara, v'levi umina lan. How do we know? The los eliku bime Ezra, that they didn't come in the time of Ezra. Dechtiv v'akabetzem el hanahar. I gather the people to the river Haba'il Ahava. The Ikbetzem Ilanahar Haba'il Ahava. Vanahane Sham Yamim Shiloshava Avina Ba'amu Bakohanim. Ubi Bene Levi Lomasati Sham. I checked the people, no Levim. Amar of Chista. The beginning, all the policemen were levim. Shneimar veshotrim halvim levnechem. The levim are shotrim. Achshav, en ma'amidim shotrim ela miYisrael. Now, we started putting them from Yisrael. Shneimar veshotrim harabim berashechem. The many shotrim are in front of you. There is no such pasuk. Pasuk ze lo nimtza betanach. Problematic item. Okay. Mishnah. Bat Yisrael, shenised lekohen. Bat Yisrael marries a kohen. Tochal betruma, she can eat teruma. Met. Like we learn, if once she's married, once she makes nisuin, she eats teruma. Met if he died. Vela hemenu ben, and she has a baby. Tochal b'truma, she could still eat teruma because of the baby. Niset levi, she marries a levi. Tochal b'maaser, now she can eat maaser.
Only maaser.
Velo b'truma. She went back to being a zara. Met if the levi dies, vela hemenu ben. She still stays eating maaser.
If not, go back to Kohen?
I don't know.
No, it's not a case of going back to Kohen.
No, if
Rashi met v'la hemen ben tochal b'maaser b'shvil bena. V'hai ben pasal la mitruma. He's posela from the truma. Sharei yesh la zera minazar uchti v'zera en la v'shava. V'hare yesh la zera. V'al v'gav dekra bebat Kohen ketiv. Marbina mine begimara bat Yisrael ha'ochel b'shvil bena Kohen.
So you're right. If she didn't have, she could go back to eating for her son.
Hilkach ki hechi debat kohen ki it la zera mi Yisrael lo hadra bat Yisrael ochel b'shvil bina kohen nami ki it la zera ben mi Levi o mi Yisrael lo hadra. She doesn't go back ochel b'shvil bina kohen. So she's a bat Yisrael. She married a kohen. She started eating teruma. She had a son from the kohen. She's eating teruma for her son. We'll call him Aharon. Then she married, her husband died. She married a Levi, right? So she stopped eating teruma because of her son Aharon, and she eats, but she's able to eat maaser because of her husband. She has a son from her husband, we'll call him Levi, right? So now she can't go back to eating teruma when her husband dies because Levi's stopping her. But she eats maaser because of Levi, but she needs a husband. Now she goes and she marries Mr. Yisrael. Niset li Yisrael. Now she can't eat not teruma and not maaser. Lo tochal, lo betruma, v'lo
b'maaser. What about the baby?
Met. She died. He died.
V'la
emenu ben, and she has a son, Yisrael. לא תאכל לא בתרומה ולא במעשר. שירה זה נהי, נא תרומה, אינה מעשר.
הכס נבא הזימון.
מת. Why, they could all eat regular. Met Bena Yisrael, her son from Yisrael dies, Tochal b'maaser. She goes back up to Maaser. Met Bena Levi, her son from the Levi dies, Tochal b'truma. She goes back to eating truma. Met Bena Kohen, the son from the Kohen dies, lo tochal, lo b'truma, lo b'maaser. She lost it all. But Kohen, she nisset li Yisrael. About Kohen who marries Yisrael, boom, lo tochal b'truma. Met. Vela hemenu ben, he died, but she has a son. He keeps a pasul. Lo tochal betruma vezera en la. Niset la Levi, she marries a Levi, so now she has a son from Israel, and she married to a Levi. Tochal b'maaser. Met, if he died, vela hemenu ben, and she has a son. Tochal b'maaser. She eats maaser because of her son. Niset la kohen. She's married to a kohen. Tochal betruma. She eats teruma. Met vela emenu ben, she has a son from the kohen. Tochal betruma. Now she eats because of the son. Everything depends on the order, right? The first G has three kids, she eats nothing. The second G has the same three kids in reverse order, she eats everything, right? Met benami kohen lo tochal betruma. She goes back down. Met benami levi lo tochal b'maaser. Met benami Israel hozer lebet aviha.
Kohen.
Yeah, על זה נאמר ושב על בית אביה כי נעוריה מלך מאביה תוכל. Classic case, huh?